Bonjour everybody, welcome back to my channel. I hope you are doing well. Today's video, we are doing a makeup haul. As you may know, there was a Black Friday going on lately and I did fail because I was supposed to be on a no buy. If you follow me on Instagram and especially on my stories, I was telling you that I was on a no buy for 3 months, which I started in a really good way, but Black Friday happened and I couldn't resist. I failed, and anyway, I will save that for another story and another video because I need to touch on my no buy situation. So I will do a video about it very soon on my channel, so stay tuned for that. So as I said, I gave in, I failed, I did some shopping, not much to be honest with you, because if you saw my last year Black Friday haul, it was crazy, it was epic, it was huge. This year is not the same. I really made sure to just spend money on things that I really wanted to have or try and not just spending for spending. So I'm still a little bit proud of myself because I didn't really went crazy. So today what we're gonna be doing is a Black Friday haul. Makeup haul, and I wanted to change a little bit my format and I wanted to try them on while I was talking about the products and sharing with you my first impression mini review on the products. I didn't try everything because I've got things that I couldn't try on because I was trying other things instead, so I won't be able to review every single product, but most of the products will be reviewed and tried on. So if you want to know what I got on Black Friday, I did buy from Beauty Bay, from Pat McGrath, but also from Boots and Sephora France. So if you want to see those products in action and what I thought about them, you know what to do. Just keep on watching. The first thing we're gonna talk about is product that I got from Beauty Bay. It's easy, I got two things from Beauty Bay and those two things are from the same brand, Jouer Cosmetics. The first one here is a lip gloss from Jouer that looks like so, and it's the high pigment lip gloss with coconut oil in the shade Fifth Avenue. So this gloss is not what I am wearing today. Today I'm wearing something else from another purchase, but definitely this is a beautiful brownish nude shade. But first thing I can see from the swatch, it's more like a very opaque lip gloss, I feel like, so it will be really beautiful on the lips. And this color is my kind of color for an everyday lip, so I'm really liking the color. I really like the smell as well. It smells like vanilla, so it's really nice. I really like the packaging of this lip gloss as well. It's very luxurious and really pretty to look at, so I'm really liking that. And it's definitely something you can throw in your bag, so it's really nice, convenient, pretty to look at, and it's really pretty as well as a color. And as you can see when I do that, it's very shiny and glossy as well. I cannot wait to put this on my lips, but I will definitely give you an update and will be using it in future video for sure. And yeah, so that's my first item from Jouer. And the second one is this one right there, and it's the Sun Swept Bronzer Duo Palette, and I have it in the light to medium duo shade. The lightest shade is Sunlight and the darkest shade is Suntan. I really like the packaging of this duo. I already have a couple of blushes from Jouer and I love the packaging. They are really nice, very sturdy as well, very travel friendly. And I really like the idea that you can have two shades from bronzer or blushes. It's really nice. And this is what I have on today. It's such a beautiful, beautiful bronzer. When I put it on, the first thing I felt is like it was very soft to the touch, but also it was very a buildable color. So I was mixing both colors, the lightest and the darkest, to give me the perfect bronzer shade. And I really like the finish of it and I'm so happy I got my hands on it. It really warms up your complexion in such a nice and pretty way. So I'm really liking this bronzer. I'm really glad I got my hands on it and I do recommend this bronzer. It's such a nice experience to apply on your cheek, and yeah, definitely beautiful packaging and a beautiful bronzer too. So next I got a few things from Boots. So the first thing I got is this beauty sponge from Morphe. This one I didn't try it today, but I will definitely be using it in an upcoming video. So I really wanted to give it a try because I've been hearing so many good things about this beauty sponge. I'm not a big customer from Morphe. Actually, I have only a couple of things from them, which is couple of brushes. One is for my under eye, it's a concealer brush, and the other one is for my lower lash line, and it's an eye brush. So that's the only thing I got from Morphe's. Oh no, I got another thing actually that I still haven't tried, and it's the Jaclyn Hill and Morphe brushes collection, the one for the face. I still haven't given it a try, so you see how crazy I am about Morphe. Anyway, so I still wanted to try this beauty sponge because I heard so many people raving about this sponge, and because it was Black Friday, even though it's already not that expensive, it's even quite affordable, but still I was like, you know what, let's just give it a try. So I grabbed this beauty sponge and I will definitely keep you updated and we'll be showcasing it in a future video. The next thing I got is from Fenty Beauty, and it's the Bomb Baby 2 Mini Lip and Face Set, which includes the Killer White Foil Freestyle Highlighter and the Gloss Bomb Universal Lip Luminizer. So here's the babies, they are so stunning. Look at this mini lip gloss. This one is in the shade Sweet Mouth. It's a light pinky shimmery gloss. And here's the packaging for the highlighter. And this is in the shade Sand Castle. So see, these two here, they are so pretty and beautiful. This lip gloss, you know, I'm in love with this formula. I just have all of them, like the three original shades, I have them all. I love them so much, and I'm so happy I got this mini one as an extra because I love this color. It's so pretty. It's a light pink shimmery gloss, and this highlighter is a little bit too dark for my skin tone, but I cannot wait to use it as an eyeshadow, fold eyeshadow all over my lid. This is going to be so stunning, especially for festivity looks, you know, things like that. It's going to be beautiful on the lid. So yeah, very happy about this purchase. The next thing I got is a highlighter from Dior. I love the packaging of it. I love that it comes in a pouch. It's so luxurious and so nice. And this velvety pouch is very useful. Dior packaging are really stunning and beautiful and very luxurious. I just love them. And especially this one has changed because it's more thinner. Before, they used to be more thicker. And this one is very thin. It doesn't take that much of space in your makeup bag, so it's really nice. And I love the back as well, they changed it as well. But the best is from the inside. Oh my gosh, when I saw that highlighter, I was like, I don't need another highlighter, to be honest with you. So I could have avoided that purchase if I want to be honest, but when I saw it online, I just fell in love with the packaging, with the style of this highlighter. And I did my research, because I didn't just buy it on a whim. I did my research, I went on YouTube, I watched reviews, I compared it with other highlighters, and seriously, I just was more in love after watching the reviews. You know what, I'm sold, I'm gonna get it, because it's such a stunning highlighter. This is what I have on today, as you can see, but it's so beautiful, it's stunning. And also what I love about this highlighter is you don't feel it when you touch it, when you swatch it, you don't feel it, you don't feel any powder, there is no fallout, there is no kickback on the pan. It's like you put air on your hands. It's crazy. It's very, very subtle. It's not bing bing on your face, but yet looks very wet, beautiful. And I love, love, love this color as well. This shade really suits my skin tone as well. It's the perfect nude highlighter. I just love it. I'm in love with this highlighter, and I'm so glad I got it, because I don't have anything like it in my collection. Anything. This is unique for me. It's a beautiful one, and I highly, highly recommend this highlighter. Another product from Dior, and this one is the Dior Skin Nude Luminizer Blush, and it's a shimmering glow blush powder that I have in the shade 11 Plump Pop. Again, I love that it comes with a velvet pouch, very useful. I love this. And also, same packaging, beautiful packaging, very luxurious. I'm just a sucker for their packaging. They are one of these luxurious brands that do not go wrong with their packaging. It's just beautiful. I love it so much. But what's inside, I think it's gonna shock you. Look at this blush. So vibrant, so pop, so rich in pigment, and very colorful, I have to say. But I'm gonna explain why I got this blush. There were just two colors actually. One was sold out, it was a peach color that I wanted first, and then was this one still left. And I was like, I'm not sure, it's a little bit too much. I'm not sure if I'm really gonna be using this blush. And I really wanted to try this formula, which is the same formula as the highlighter. And I was like, you know what, I'm gonna just try it, because this blush may seem crazy in the pan, but maybe it's going to be really pretty on the cheek. So I got it. I wasn't sure what I was doing, but I was like, you know what, let's try it, we never know. So I got it, and let me tell you, when I applied it on, look at this cheek. I have it on my cheek right now. It doesn't seem like crazy cheeks, right? It doesn't seem like, oh my god, what she has on her cheek, it's too plumpy, it's too rosy, it's too colorful. Absolutely not. And as you can see in the demo, it just blends beautifully. The pigment is there, it's very buildable. You can have it sheer and you can have it very bright, very intense. So it really depends on your personal preferences, it depends on the look you are going for that day, it really depends. You can articulate the color around your needs of the day. And this is why I'm so impressed by this blush, because it looks crazy on the pan. Look at this swatch, it looks crazy, right? I mean, you can see it from far, really. Look at that. You can see it from far. You can even use it as an eyeshadow on your lid, and it can make a beautiful eye look as well. It can also make a monochromatic look as well by using it on your lid, by using it on a cheek, and having a similar color on your lips. It's such a beautiful color, and I'm so glad I got it, because it's not that crazy on the cheek, and you can really make it versatile, and you can really play around the color. You can make it sheer, as I said, and you can make it brighter and darker if you want to. So I'm so glad I got it. It's so beautiful, and plus for me, this color, it's just perfect for winter, for this current season, because you can do such a nice winter lounge makeup look with it. And yeah, you can play with it. So it's just, I'm so glad I got it. And as I said, it's the same formula as the highlighter, and there's no kickback, there's no fallout, there's nothing coming off the pen. So it's wonderful, it's beautiful, it's perfect. I love that color, even though it looks crazy when you see it first. I'm so glad I got it, and again, I have nothing as this blush in my collection, so this blush has a big thumbs up for me. Next box, it's from Pat McGrath, and yet again I got something from her, from the Mothership of Makeup. And per usual, she knows how to make a beautiful package, and it's very frou-frou, very luxe, and also very festive. And yeah, every time I got something from her, it's always Christmas, you know. Not just right now, but all year around, it's that kind of packaging. It really makes the experience even more luxurious and more special. That's what we're gonna say. So I have to say, this order, I didn't plan on doing it, but when I found out online that she was releasing mini lipsticks and different kind of lipstick, I was like, oh yes, because I love her formula for the matte lipstick. I have only one lipstick, and it's in the shade Donatella. It's the perfect nude. I love that lipstick so much. I was like, you know what, it's amazing that I can try out minis from her, mini lipsticks. And she released not just one type of lipstick, which is like the matte formula, but she's also released the lip glosses that I never tried and I really wanted to try out. Here's the trio of her Lust Gloss. So here's Flesh Fantasy, very glossy and smells so good, smells vanilla. Here's Bronze Temptation, looks like between a corally and red colors, I feel like. And you can spot some shimmers in it. And the last one is Flesh 4, which looks more like a brown, dark brown. Yeah. This is her lip glosses. I never tried her lip glosses formula before, so for me it's the first time, and I'm really glad. From the swatches, what I can see is that they are quite pigmented, but very glossy and quite opaque as well, so very rich in color, and I love that. I hope they're not going to be too sticky on the lips. I will have to double check that, and we'll let you know, of course, but I'm really liking the color. Very nice, very versatile, very different from one another, which is great. Then she released mini matte lipstick, and this is the formula I just told you about and that I love. I'm so happy that I can get three other shades. And these are the packaging of the minis matte trends lipstick. So here's OMI. This is such a beautiful pinky movie everyday shade. This is Flesh Free, which is more like a darker brown. a beautiful shade as well, and this is 1995. Such a beautiful nude as well. I mean, look at this, so stunning. I love this trio, I love this shade. Those are my shades. Wrap up my eyelid, this is the kind of shade I can wear every single day. The pinky movie, the brownish, and the nude. Oh my god, this is my trio shades. Seriously, it's like she made them for me. I'm so happy, so glad. Oh my gosh, so happy. And the last but not the least is the one I tried today. It's their lip balms. And again, I heard so many people raving about those lip balms. And when she released this trio of lip balms, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna get all of them and I'm gonna have a good go and try them on and I will be super happy. And guess what? I am super happy because those lip balms, oh my gosh, they are so pigmented, they are so rich, so glossy on the lips, but also so hydrating. It's crazy. You're gonna see in the demo, I used the clear lip balm because I knew I was going to use a regular lipstick. Now I get all the hype about those lip balms because if I compare them with the luxurious lip balm I have, this is completely different and this is way better than what I already tried from the luxurious brands. So this is something if you want to splurge on, you can, because they are worth it. And those are called the Mini Lip Fetish Lip Balm Trio. Then you've got the shade Flesh 3 Lip Fetish Sheer Color Balm. Then you've got the shade Blow Up Lip Fetish Sheer Color Balm. And then the one I'm using today is the Clear Lip Fetish Lip Balm. Again, I just love those packaging. They are so cute and stunning. And those lip balms are phenomenal, fantastic, so hydrating, and very pigmented for lip balms, seriously. And if you haven't tried those minis, I highly recommend them because as I said earlier, it's such a great way to try out her formulas on her lippies. So that way I got to try her balmy formula, her lipstick formula, but also her lip glosses formula, which is amazing because it really allowed me to try a good amount of shades from her. Definitely go check them out because they are really fantastic, and I will leave a link in the description box on all these products as well. The last but not the least is a box from Sephora. Ta-da! Sephora France to be precise. But I've been really good because I got only two products, and the products I got are from the same brand and it's from Huda Beauty. So the first thing I got is this eyeshadow palette and it's the Huda Beauty Medium Nude Obsession. And if you know me and you've been around for quite some time, you know I love my minis from Huda Beauty. And funny story is that I do not own any of her biggest palettes, none of them. I only own the minis because I really do love them so much, and I got one of each category, so I've got them all. And I was debating on this one, I wasn't sure if I wanted to get a nude palette because I do have other nudes and I'm pretty much, you know, all fine with my nudes that I already own. But the little obsession I have over her mini palette got me. And when I saw that Sephora France was having a Black Friday on Huda palettes and especially on the minis, I was like, you know what, it's Black Friday, it's discounted. I think I had 20 or 25% off of this palette. And I was like, you know what, I do love her minis, I love her shadows formula. So I was like, I need to have this one at least to try out and to see if it's really that good. So I got it. She released three different shades, light, medium, dark, or rich, I don't remember the exact name. And I got the medium one. And of course, when I opened it, I really liked what I saw. This beautiful palette of nudes, I just love it. I love that you've got mattes and shimmers. I love that the mattes are very nudish but still very warm as well. And I love that the shimmers also are very warm, but it really complements the matte shades as well, so that's really great. And when I applied it on my eyes, because this is what I have today on my eyes, and you're gonna see in the demo, the shadows are very pigmented, they blend really well together, they are very easy to work with. But yes, there is a but, because as I told you earlier, I'm in love with her minis. I just love them so much. But what I'm trying to say is that the other ones, when I tried them on, it was love at the first sight. Love at the first sight. I fell in love immediately. I felt inspired by the color scheme. I felt like the palette were versatile. I could do so many looks from those palettes, you know. But when I tried this one on today and I was playing around with the colors, I wasn't feeling that inspired, you know, when I was looking at the palette. I wasn't feeling like there was something magical or something very unique, or I could do versatile looks with it, you know. I feel like all the colors really, not they're all the same, of course they are not, but they are very similar. And that's why maybe I didn't feel that inspiration and I wasn't like, oh my gosh, blown away like the others. No, this one is more like, you can live without, you know, it's not a necessity. It's not gonna be like a plus-value in your collection as well. It's not, I don't know, I'm not disappointed. I still need to play with it, okay? I still need to see what kind of looks I can do with it, because I really like the look I created. You know, it's really nice, very pretty. And as I said, the shadows are very pigmented and very easy to work with. But it wasn't like love at the first sight. That's the thing. I don't know why. So that's my first impression on this palette. I love the packaging. I love the color scheme. But I don't know, there is something missing and I cannot point my finger on it, but it's not like the others. I don't know what it is about, but definitely it's not an essential, it's not a must-have, and you can live without. Maybe I'm not that very creative, let's say, so maybe that's why I'm a little bit stuck right now. But maybe later on, when I'm gonna be playing with it a little bit more, I will be able to open up my creativity and see more looks through that palette. So I will definitely keep you updated on this palette, and I will definitely be using it in future video, creating other looks, and see if my first impression will change or if it will stay the same. Keep an eye on that. But if you have it, if you own it, let me know in the comment below what are your thoughts about it, because maybe, I don't know, there's something I don't see on it and I'm missing on it. Let me know what are your thoughts about it, because I'm really curious about how you feel about this palette. If you own also the others, let me know how you feel about it. Maybe I'm just the only one thinking like this, I don't know, and I'm weird, I don't know. Let me know in the comment below. And the last but not the least, we got a throwback lip set, which includes a lip contour in the shade HBIC and a power bullet in the shade Board Meeting. First of all, love the packaging. I do have another one like so, but not in the same packaging. I think it was more satin, something like that. This one is more matte, because we are having on my lips a matte lipstick formula. And as I said, this is what I have on my lips today. It's the Lip Duo Huda Beauty, and this lip combo, I love it. Right off the bat, when I applied the lip contour on my lips, I just knew I was going to love it, because I do have another Huda Beauty lip liner, which I love as well, and I love the formula of those lip liner. They are very long lasting, but yet very creamy on the lips and very comfortable, and also you can really contour your lip in such an easy way. So I love that. And the bullet formula, oh my gosh, I love it as well. Oopsie daisy. First of all, I love the packaging of the lipstick. Plus here you've got it in a brown shade, because the shade you have on the bullet is the shade you have on the lipstick. So it's really nice, because if you have other ones, at least when you see this one, you know it's from the nude range and it's the matte formula. And I love the formula of it. It's such a beautiful lipstick. I love the color of it. It's a brown nude shade, perfect for an everyday shade, as you can see. And I just love this type of shade, because they are easy to wear. They go with anything, any look. Like here, I've got a purpley, rosy eye look. And with the brown lips, it really pair well together. So this is a no-brainer for me. I love the formula of the lipstick. And when I say I love the formula, it's because I love that it's very comfortable on the lips, yet it's a matte lipstick, so it has a matte finish, but with a satin matte finish, so it's very creamy, very balmy on the lips, but it does not last for a very long time. So I wouldn't say it's a long lasting. The lip liner though, it's a long lasting formula. This one not so much. After you eat or you drink, it fades away, but it fades away in a very pretty way. So it's not like you're having it all over your mouth. not at all, or on your chin, not at all. It's fading really nicely, so don't worry about that. But this is a kind of formula you will have to reapply throughout the day. So that's the only thing I wanted to say. I love the formula of the lip liner as well, so these two together, it's the duo gagnant, the duo winner. I love it. I do not regret this purchase and I'm really glad I got this color. This is my kind of shade, so I'm super happy and I'm glad I got my hands on them. And there you go guys, we are done with this Black Friday try on haul. I hope you liked this type of format, a little bit different from what I do usually, but I hope you liked it. If you do like this type of format, let me know in the comment below and I will keep doing them in the future, or at least from time to time. And I hope you found this video entertaining. Maybe you find new gems that you wanna try yourself. Or maybe you already own those products and you have your own thought about it, and I would love to hear from you. So let me know in the comment below if you did try those products. So I really hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did film it. And if it's the case, don't hesitate to give me a big thumbs up. It really helps me a lot. And if you are new to my channel, I hope you will consider subscribing before you leave. I would love for you to join our YouTube family. And if you want to help me a little bit more, don't hesitate to share this video with your friends or family. That also will help me a lot. I really want to reach the 1K mark by the end of December, or maybe even in January, to start off 2020 in a good foot. So please help me reaching 1K of subscribers. That will mean the world to me. So thank you so much for watching, for spending this time with me today, and I cannot wait to see you in my next video. Until then, stay beautiful. Mwah. Bye.